Diamond Monsters, welcome back. If you haven't already, then please do press the big red subscribe button. And the reason why my hair isn't looking as pristine as half of my YouTube videos, let's be real, my hair never looks pristine, but still, hi, how are you? Because today we are going to do a drag transformation. I'm really excited, I cannot wait. This is going to be a real good turnout, and I'm really buzzed, and I can't wait for you guys to see the video. I've already done my brows. Remember guys, if they aren't twinning, it's because brows are sisters and not twins. But anyway, without further ado, let's jump into the video. So like all drag queens, you cannot be a drag queen unless your hair is gone. So this is what this is for. So we're just going to pull back my hair, guys. Hi, how are you? Legit, we're gonna pop it over the hair, just like so. It looks crazy, it looks weird, it looks bizarre right now. But it's gotta look crazy, weird, and bizarre right now. We've gotta move that brown line back because we're gonna have to draw another brown line on, and I'll explain that in the video. So we're then just covering the hair just like so. And as you can tell, the face already kinda looks quite done. So, of course, I've already primed, I've already moisturised. We're legit just going to cover up some spots of mine that I don't like at the moment, that are quite red and sore, but who gives a damn? So we're going to cover up these and we're going to get them going. So first things first, we're going to jump in with the Unique Touch Liquid Foundation, and this is the shade Organza. This is a liquid foundation, shake before wash use, 24 hours wear. I want to do a 24 hour challenge makeup that could be coming soon. So of course we're going to give it a good old shake like it recommends. Then it has a little squirty bit up here, so we can just squirt the foundation on, and then we're just going to take our beauty blender. Lovely. I think it's gone. Think it's actually gone, guys. If not, then we can take the spray foundation that I have from Unique. Yep, we're gonna take the spray foundation. So how this spray foundation works, guys, is legit. It's like pretty much like a spray bottle. So we're just gonna spray our face, shake it well first, guys. Always shake your foundation first. If it says on there shake first, make sure you shake first. Okay, and we're then just going to spray the foundation. Ooh. Hi, how are you? Okay, we're going to spray onto the beauty blender instead because I don't like how that hits my face whatsoever. Okay, and then we're of course then just going to apply that to the face, just like so. This actually looks really, really smooth, this foundation, I'm not gonna lie. I might have to order some more. I forgot how smooth on camera this actually looks, and it actually is my shade. Hi, spray again, and then just spray onto the beauty blender, just like so, guys. This is also 24 hours wear. I can see that it's full coverage, so we don't really need to judge the coverage on that, really. I'm not gonna lie, because I think you guys can see as well, it is a lovely full coverage foundation. Hi, how are you? I'm a little bit shook, I'm not gonna lie. We're gonna be using mostly Unique products today, so really, yeah, just really, yeah. Hi, how are you? And I love the smoothness of this, it's just like so. Again, we're just gonna spray some more on there, just like so. I don't like how it sprays onto the face. That's the only problem with this, is the way it sprays. I don't like that. That felt weird. So we're just gonna apply it with a beauty blender instead. So spray it onto a beauty blender if you don't like the spray effect like me. Just spray it onto the beauty blender and then just apply like normal foundation. Now, of course, you wanna get right up into your hairline for this. And you want to properly, basically you want a really good full coverage. I ain't gonna lie, you want the best full coverage you can find. And this one, I think we may have achieved it. I'm not going to lie. Hi, how are you? Again, we're just gonna apply some to the nose, but again, avoiding the piercing. on my nose because, hi Pearson, how are you? I really shouldn't be doing YouTube videos, but do I follow instructions? Nope, why? Because that's me. So again, we're just spraying more. I really should dab this beauty blender, but it's working quite nicely, quite dry, I'm not gonna lie. Then we're gonna use the unique concealer, then we are gonna use our concealer, guys, just to lighten up some areas and to really, really basically get them working and to really cover up some of these spots on the face. As I like to call it, acne, which is the actual correct word for it. Hi English, how are you? I love how full coverage this actually looks. Wow, I've never seen such full coverage foundation. I'm not even joking. On the monitor, that looks, whoo, girl, this is the next level. Hi Unique, how are you? Whew. Their makeup is quite expensive, but I never would normally say this about a makeup brand, but it is worth it, I reckon. Look how full coverage that is on me. And then we're gonna take our Love Revolution concealer and we are then just going to conceal my eyes just like so. Or underneath my eyes just like so. Hi concealer, how are you? And we're then just going to dab that out nicely. Just like so. I'm not sure how much this spray retails for, but if you are interested, it's all down below. Links and everything, all down below. Go ahead and have a look at that too, guys. Because why not? Okay, I'm not gonna lie, that is looking quite, and I'm really loving this, I'm not going to lie. Hi, how are you? I think what we are just gonna do is stick to a basic drag look, like a normal glam. We're not gonna do, should we do a nice eyeshadow? Sod it, yeah, we'll do a nice eyeshadow. We'll then just concealing this part of my face too, underneath the eyes. Really getting into those gaps in their pores, just like so. Okay. This is turning out much more better than I thought it would with this foundation, I'm not gonna lie. Hi, how are you? Whoo, girl. And then all we are going to do, now, I know it's going to sound crazy, I said I would use e.l.f., but this foundation was more softer and smoother for the areas. And then all we are then, foundation, concealer, hello. And then all we are then going to do is take a C1 concealer, that was the C2 concealer. And we are going to add this C1 concealer to here, just like so. And then we're going to apply it to here and here. Just really, really cover that whole entire area up and to really get that effect. Dabbing that in nicely. And then all we are then going to do is take our airbrushed beauty blenders and we are then just going to quickly and nicely just go over the face one more time. Now, reason why we are doing that is so basically it leaves it nice, smooth and clear. So again, nice, just like so. You can buy these little small beauty blenders in the Outlook in Gunwolf. These were, I think, £2, sorry, for about 8. So bargains. And they're actually really, really good because they make your face, they make the makeup, they make everything just look and airbrushed, which is the effect we need for a drag queen. I'm not going to lie. So I have now blended everything as far as I can see out nicely, just like so. And then all we are going to do is we're going to take Unique's setting powder, guys. I'm nervous for this because I've never used it before and we're about to use it. So we're going to take the Unique's setting powder. This is in, what shade is this? doesn't say a shade. It just says unique translucent setting powder. So, and again, like we all know and you all trust, we take a big puffy brush, just like so. Hi. Oh, okay, this best look be good. We're then gonna dab that on. I'm actually using a monitor for once. Hi, how are you? There we go. Once you have dabbed all that on and made sure you have covered every possible area, including around your brows, even if you haven't put foundation in your brows, you would have concealed them as well. So just make sure you put powder over your brows so the concealer is kind of set nicely. Now, oh, I'm not going to lie, that setting powder is looking quite good. Whew. Okay. Why is this going so well? Hi, how are you? And now then, once you've done that, we're just gonna avoid the piercing again. There we go. Now, I'm one of those who love my face being set, so we're gonna add another real quick layer of setting powder again, just like so. There we go. I have so unorganized for this video. I have moved the studio around, so there's makeup here, and there's makeup here too. So, yeah. And again, you really want to just make sure you buff it out around your hairline. Don't worry so much if along the cap here, if it hasn't got foundation there or anything, because the wig you will put on will cover that up. So, don't stress too much about that. Now we have done that, I ain't gonna lie, that looks quite flawless, it looks quite fresh. I'm actually not hating it, I'm actually really, really, really like dying for it. So that was the Unique Touch Spray Foundation, guys. And that was so, it's just, the coverage on it is so good. And then we have the Unique Setting Powder as well, guys. I'm not gonna lie, I'm living for these products. They are very expensive, but so worth the money, and I definitely need to order some more. So now, bronzer, guys, we are going to grab all of my makeup. Some things are gonna drop on the floor. There we go, so we have all the makeup here. Hi, how are you? And then we are legit just going to take, I really wanna feel like using this bronzer, but at the same time, we're just going to spice things up a little bit, guys. And we're going to take the Model's Own bronzer, and we're going to use the bronzer Google picked in my last YouTube video. If you haven't yet seen that, what are you doing? You need to go and see it. So we're going to use the same bronzer that Google picked before, this one here, because I'm not going to lie, that bronzer actually made me look quite, and drag is quite OTT, so it will absolutely look incredible, and we want to bronze for the gods. So now we're going to bronze. I'm really, really nervous because this bronzing could go right or wrong. And by the looks of it, it's beginning to go right. There we go, just like so. And then we're gonna go back in with the same bronzing shade there, guys. And we are gonna bronze all the way up here. Now again, like I said, don't stress too much if it's OTT, the bronzer, because the bronzer, again, this is drag. So you're meant to look a little bit, like a little bit burned, but not too burned. Does that make sense? You'll know if you're too burned because they'll legit be dark, 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 dark. Whereas this burn, this burnt, on the other hand, it's kind of cute from what I can see in the monitor anyway. Just like so. And then of course we are then just going in with more bronzer, and we are then just going to bronze the other side of the face. Now this bronzer doesn't actually look that bad, I'm not gonna lie, especially for drag. And now it looks really, really dark in the packaging, but if you are careful and you do it nicely, this bronzer is actually perfect for drag. Now, most drag queens do cover their brows, but I'm not going to do that today because that step is long and it takes a good couple of hours to actually do that bit. So I'm going to try to avoid it. Dry, we are avoiding it, guys, because we don't want any problems. So what we are going to do, because I have, of course, the nose piercing, we're going to take a little eyeshadow brush for this, and we're then just going to add the bronzer to the nose. There with the eyeshadow brush, blending it out around the piercing so it's not too bad. Eye makeup tips, how are ya? And then of course, because you want your face, your whole entire face to kind of change, all you are then going to do is add some bronzer to the area there, because you want your nose to look, and you want your whole entire face to basically look completely different, which is the look we are going for right here. And then we're going to do the jawline too, because we want the jawline popping. I'm not going to lie, especially if you're a drag queen, a good jawline for a drag queen is, whew. Hi, how are you? Blend up if you're going to do your jawline, because it will define your jawline a lot more, as you can tell. Hi, how are you? And then we're going to do exactly the same on this side, guys. There we go. Applying it behind the ears too. Just like so. There we go. And then blending it up there as well on your chin. To get rid of a double chin, if you have one, legit, you're just going to brush like so. There we go. We are actually living for that. Hi, how are you? And then just to make sure it's all firmly blended out nicely, we're going to take our buffer brush and we are going to buff all that bronzer out. Just like so. I'm not gonna lie, this is the smoothest I have probably ever seen my face up close. I'm actually loving setting powder and everything. I'm here like, girl, I have legit just smashed 2020's drag. Hi, how are you? Of course, you're gonna have to buff out the forehead and everything a little bit nicer, and the sides a little bit nicer too, because but at the same time we want it to look as natural as possible. Now, the reason why we have put this cap on now is because it makes it so much easier if you have hair like mine that looks horrible. It just makes it so much more easier, I'm not gonna lie to you guys. And as you can tell, my face is already beginning to look completely different. I'm not gonna lie, I'm not hating it. But at the same time, I'm kind of liking it. But at the same time, I need to keep that there, please. Thank you. There we go. Now, once you have done that, normally you would spend a little bit longer on bronzer. But we're going to spice things up a little bit more. We're just going to add a little bit more bronzer. But we're going to add the lighter shade here, guys. And all we are going to do is apply in the exact same place. But on the edges, so it kind of blends out the dark ones. Does that make sense? The dark bronzer. Hi, how are you? Because if you do like the dark, blend out the dark blonde bronzer, I cannot speak today. With a light bronzer, then hi, it begins to, oh my god, I just put it in a dark bronzer, it begins to look a little bit more natural, and that is the look we are going for. There we go. Now that is that done, guys. Of course, the next step is eyeshadow. Now, I'm living for bright colours at the moment. So, of course, you all know we love James Charles palette here, guys. Normally, I would dive in straight away with this pillow. What the hell? This palette, but we're going to spice it up a bit, guys. And we are legit going to use Jawbreaker, because Jawbreaker has more brighter colours in it, it's a little bit more pigment, and it's perfect for drag. So what we are going to do is we're going to take a blending brush, just like so, and the Jawbreaker palette. I don't know about you guys, but I'm really feeling like an orangey and yellowy sort of colour. So we're going to go in with the orange and the yellow, guys, okay? So the first things first is we're going to dive in with Suck in the Jawbreaker palette, and we're going to apply that to the crease, just like so. Now applying that softly and gently and in circular motions as well. Now I've only dabbed twice in Suck with this brush, and I have a very thin brush, as you can see, very thin brush. Once we've done this eyeshadow, we're going to pop off camera and do the other eye off camera. But just so you guys can see how I have done this eyeshadow, which is the whole point of this YouTube video. There we go. So we have applied the orange on there nicely. Hi brush, you're breaking. We need to order more. I've had these for a while. And then of course, we're just going to apply a little bit more into the crease, blending that out nicely. And then going in with a nice clean brush again, and a nice like thin one, we're going to dive in with a little bit of a darker orange. But unfortunately, there's not a darker orange in here, so we have to find a darker orange. We're gonna spice it up. We're gonna dive in with the red in here, guys. But instead of going in with this red, we're gonna go in with cherry wet red, guys, because it's a little bit more light, darker, and it really can work. And then all we are then gonna do is blend that in with the orange ever so nicely and carefully, just like so. There we go. And once you have blended that into the orange nicely, there we go. Hi, how are you? And then of course, taking another clean brush, we are then just taking your concealer and your concealer brush, guys, we're just going to conceal the eyelids, because we want the eyelids quite, and we want the yellow to pop. That's the whole reason for this. So now we are going just to conceal the eyelids, just like so. There we go. And as you can tell, I'm not brushing it on, I'm dabbing it on. And then once you have done that, you are going to take your airbrush beauty blender, and you are then just going to brush, dab that concealer in nicely. Once that concealer is nicely and dabbed in, then you can dive in to add in the yellow. Make sure that concealer is all nicely blended in though. And now we can officially dive in with Wow in the Jeffree Star palette. This brush is quite like chunky and has no like texture or anything to it. So we're gonna dive in. Is this brush clean? I don't know, because I don't clean my brushes. And then we are then just going to do this into Wow. And then we are then just going to apply that Wow onto the eyelid, just like so. Now I'm really feeling like this look at the moment, and I don't know why. With lashes on, I feel like this look would just be so complete, it's unreal. And then we're going to add a nice little sparkly, like yellow onto this as well. And then we're going to take that big chunky brush I just said we wasn't going to use a minute ago, and we're then just going to apply that to the eyelid, just like so, because we really want that yellow popping, but not too much, because we don't want the yellow to overtake the orange. We want it nice and subtle. just like so. See that? Cute. And then we are then going to take another brush. Hello, I'm dropping brushes right now. And then we're going to take another brush, and then we're going to blend out the orange with that brush nicely. And then we're going to blend in the yellow in with that orange too, ever so nicely. Just like so, because we want it to look cute, but not overpowering. Does that make sense? Oh, it's hard work sitting here. My legs are hurting because I'm sat here with them crossed, and I'm here like, hi, how are you? And then of course, we are going to take a little packing brush. As you all know, I love good packing brushes. And then we are going to dive in with the lemon drop here, guys. And we are then just going to brush that on. And we're going to dab that nicely onto the yellow, because this will make the yellow just stand out so much more nicer. And it will look so much more cuter. Just like so. There we go. And as you can tell, the yellow and the orange really stand out. And then of course, I'm gonna go off camera quickly and do the other eye, and then we'll move on to guys. So I've just very quickly popped on lashes and completed the other eye. This is the eyeshadow look complete. Now the lashes, I'm not gonna lie, they complete the look. I'm here like, hi, how are you? But anyway, oh shoot, there goes the freaking like 36 pound foundation. Hi, how are ya? And basically guys, we are just going to very quickly add some more setting powder. Drag queens, when I tell you, they are set for the gods. I am not joking. We are set for the gods, because we're on stage, we're dancing, and when we're dancing, we produce sweat, and when we sweat, the makeup will all begin to come off. So we've really got to lock everything in place, which is what I am doing here, basically, guys. I'm not gonna lie, hi, how are you? So once we have done this, then we can move on to the highlighting and everything else, and the lips. Now the lips, they are normally overdrawn. In fact, not normally, they always are like overdrawn, but I don't know why, but something about that just does not go. That's my personal opinion. I don't really like that on myself. On other people, it looks cute, it looks amazing, but on myself, I look like I've just had a fucked up, botched lip done. And we ain't having that done this year, girls and boys. Absolutely not. So today we're gonna go in with the Unique Splash Lipstick. I don't know what shade this is, but it's a really cute shade. Shade? Oh my God, I cannot speak today. But we are gonna dive in with this lipstick because it's nice and red, and it looks kind of, it's like red, but not a slutty red. I know, shocker. Normally I would go in with a slutty red. But at the same time, I'm really feeling a nude. I'm not too sure. No, we're going to go in with Jeffree Star's nude lipstick. Because, hi Jeffree, how are you? So all the makeup, as you know, is down below me. So we're going to go in with the iconic Jeffree Star lipstick. This is in shade Gemini. So I'm just going to give it a good old shake because, hi, how are you? Where is my other lip liner? There. Okay, so we have our lip liners here, guys. We just need to match the lip liner. This is not a Jeffree Star lip liner, I know. Breaking the law, yes, sue me. That's fine, I have nothing, but you can try to sue me if you wish. And now we are just going to legit just follow my normal lips, guys, and get them proper like shaped, and then we're gonna fill the rest in with color. So, if it's quiet, my apologies, but let's concentrate. Okay, so that is the lip lining done. All we're going to do is dive in with the Jeffree Star lipstick, and we're gonna moist my lips and apply that color just like so. When I say apply, I mean apply. Don't just be there like, oh, we'll just add a little bit. I mean, you want heavy layers, because if they're heavy layers, then you know your lips are going to look good, smudged and snuggable, which is what we want. So There we go, just lick the lips again and just move it all about. That is the lips done, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Now, as you can tell, my face is really coming together lady-wise. So all we are going to have to do to complete the lady-wise look face is we are going to dive in with the X Morphe James Charles palette for a lovely highlighter, because we all drag queens, we love a good highlighter. We gag for a highlighter. Legit, we will go around sucking as many dicks as we can to get to a good highlighter. How does that sound? And no, before anyone asks, no. And we're gonna dive in with this shade here for highlighter. The only reason why this one is because you're about to find out. I don't really need to explain, really, because when I do it, you guys are legit about to see it and go, wow. Okay, are you ready? Work. See that? That's cute. The highlighter as well really brings a drag look together, along with lashes and your base coat of foundation. Hence why I do not really use the Unique spray foundation on all of my YouTube videos. I would only use it for drag because it is legit perfect for drag. Because I legit feel like I have nothing on. I'm here like, okay, do I have makeup on? And look in the monitor, I'm like, ooh, girl, hi, how are you? So yeah, and then we're then just gonna keep blending and brushing that on very nicely. We are using a very big, light, fluffy brush. And then we're of course gonna finish it off a little bit more, just like so, because we want that popping like it is there, guys. We look so flawless, it's unreal. Hi, how are you? See what I mean? Highlighter pops. Now, whew, go. Hi, of course, highlighter to the brows too. We want a good highlighting to the brows as well, because that will just complete it. Oh, look, you can see the highlighting. That's adorable. You can see the eyeshadow just brushing off every time I dab it. That's cute. I didn't notice that. Hi, how are you? Now we have added highlighter there. We're of course going to add a little bit more, guys, to the brow bone up here, because we really want to like glow. We want to look as feminine as possible. So yeah, following the brows that you have drawn on, or your natural brows in this case, which is me, we're then just going to brush, not really brush so much, dab the highlighter on, because we really really want it just to pop and shine. And then of course, to make the lips look a little bit more nicer, we're going to apply a little bit of highlighter to the lips too. Just like so. So it really brings the look together. And I pretty much think that is everything, guys. I'm not going to lie. The highlighting and everything looks smashed. Everything looks good. And as you can tell, the bronzing, I never usually look this bronze, but it's time we shove on the wig for the real results. Let's say hi. And that is the complete finished look, guys. And I cannot say how impressed I am of this look. It looks so realistic, it looks unreal. We look fierce as hell. Now, if you like this video, guys, don't forget to press the big red subscribe button, come and join the Diamond Monsterhood. We'd love to have you on board. And as well, if you haven't already, then please do press the big like button too. And as well, don't forget to share as well. And also, for more behind the scene things and more updates for when I'm going to be recording a YouTube video, then all you have to do is follow my Snapchat as shown above. And also, guys, if you want to go and show your love and support on my Instagram and like some pictures that are coming, then all you need to do is follow my Instagram too. My car.